Hey, you can use GoFundMe to pay for college, but there are some secrets to success I've learned by using GoFundMe to raise money for other events and endeavors I've been a part of. Stay tuned. You don't want to miss this video. On, if you followed us through the Taco Bell series where we taught you how to win the 2020 Live Más Taco Bell scholarship, then you know you had to create a 30-second to 2-minute video about your passion. In the last video for that series, I think it was called Congratulations, the Taco Bell scholarship, I told you you can repurpose that submission to help you raise more money to go to college and graduate debt free, and I specifically mentioned GoFundMe. Also in my video, how to pay for college without debt, I listed 8 different ways you can pay for college without ever having to take out a student loan. And the last way was to fundraise or to use GoFundMe. My name is Danielle Jeffers. I'm the founder of Doe 4 Degrees LLC. Doe 4 Degrees is a scholarship coaching company where I teach students how to earn scholarships to go to college and graduate debt-free. I graduated debt-free from Virginia Tech on May 17th of 2019, having earned more than $200,000 in scholarships. And so there are a couple of secrets I've learned while using GoFundMe to fundraise for one of my most recent business endeavors, the In My Bag Tour. I collaborated with two of my best friends, now my best friends, Corey Hackett Green and Kevin Stevenson, to give back to my hometown of Danville, Virginia, and Corey's hometown of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. We gave more than 500 book bags filled with school supplies and 200 teacher appreciation gifts between those two cities. And we did that in the summer of 2019, in August of 2019 to be specific. Now all three of us, we are Virginia Tech graduates, entrepreneurial Virginia Tech graduates, and we had the desire within ourselves to give back to our hometowns. But we didn't necessarily have the money to do it. And so we did a GoFundMe campaign and we raised more than $10,000 in a month and a half to give back to our hometowns. Now, $10,000 in a month and a half, all of us are 20-year-olds, I'm 22, Kevin's 23, Corey's 25, never having done this type of endeavor together before, and we did it, yo, let me tell you straight up, it was mind-blowing, it was impactful. I'm gonna insert a recap video right here, the Philadelphia one, so you can check it out.
We the best music!
Back to back every year for like 10. Pregnant with my mom's doctor told her it was slim. Was bedroom for 9 months but gave birth in the end. Pops turned 60, he proud what we done. In one generation he came from Africa young. He said he met my mom's at the Century Club. Los Angeles love, kinda like hustle and book. Money turned 10, cross turned 2. Starting to see this life from a bird's view. We the ones that made millions off the curve. Fool in this rap, 10. Never made nerd moves.
Hey, whoa. You keep taking me higher and higher. Yeah.
Callie.
But don't you know that the devil is a liar? Hey. I know.
Right back.
They'd rather see me down, put my soul in the fire. But we keep going higher, higher.
Nick, talk to him. Emptied out the it was broad day. Cause always gotta learn the hard way. We gon' tape it off if we ball play. Put a half a moon crescent on your ball fade. Police hit the lights, that's a car chase. Looking back at my life, make my heart race. Dance with the devil and test all faith. I was thinking chess moves, but it was God grace. Crooked to ever till we all straight. With no shame, I peep game and it's all fake. South Central state of mind, high crime rate. Homicide, hate gang banging to get you all day. Look at my face.
You keep taking me higher and higher.
Told Calabas to phone to the bar break.
But don't you know that the devil is a liar? I know. They'd rather see me down, put my soul in the fire. But we keep going higher, higher.
decided to take action within our neighborhoods. This is our second giveaway this year. You know, we just found places that meant close to us and just decided to take action. Teachers need to be appreciated as well. They do tons of hard work beyond just being educators, whether they're nurses, cops, guidance counselors, all the different things that they do. We understand the importance to be able to celebrate them as well.
We keep going higher.
What'd you think? Let me know in the comments if you liked that video. Stay tuned because the 2020 tour is coming to you this summer, the summer of 2020. You don't want to miss it. Go ahead and go to our website if you want to join us on the 2020 tour. The cities and all the announcements will be posted by around, say, April or May of 2020. So let's get back to helping you get money to pay for college. The GoFundMe campaign you use to pay for college, these are the secrets I learned. So GoFundMe is all about telling a story. You shouldn't just create a profile and put it up, post the link one time more on Facebook, and expect people to donate enough money to help you reach your fundraising goal. You have to give them a reason why they should invest and tell a story that compels them to donate to your cause. So let me bring you back to the Taco Bell scholarship. You submitted a video. Video is the best form of communication. Now, in your video, you want to tell your story, why you want to go to college, where you're from, what you hope to aspire to do, what you're majoring in. If you already accomplished some things, mention that as well. If you've had some hardships, mention that as well. Tell a compelling story, okay? Encourage them to donate to you because, A, you'll do what you say you're going to do, go to school and get an education, and B, because you're not going to scam them, you're not going to just take the money and pocket the money because it is going to go directly to you and use it to buy clothes or shoes, but you're going to use it to get your education. So tell a story through videos and pictures. I encourage you to make a budget. Budget out exactly where this money is going. What's the cost of your tuition? What's the cost of your room and board? What are your fees? Give them an itemized budget so people can see how you're going to use the money responsibly. That's something we did for the In My Bag tour. We had an itemized budget. We're going to use this much money for travel, this much money for promotion, this much money to get the supplies so we can give back, all of those things. But most importantly, update them. What we typically did was we posted about 2 to 3 updates per week saying, hey, thanks, we've reached the fundraising goal for this week of maybe $3,000. So far, we've been able to purchase the domain, order the supplies, and make sure we can get to one of the cities to promote boots on the ground style by actually going around and passing flyers. Those are different ways to keep people updated through pictures and videos. And you want to show pictures of what you're doing. So maybe post a picture of you being able to actually go buy your first textbook. I don't know, what have you, but keep them updated. Keep them tuned in. Make it like a series or a documentary on GoFundMe. And that'll help you get the bag, get the money you need. But be legit, be honest, and be responsible, y'all. Once again, go ahead and check out the GoFundMe campaign we use to raise more than $10,000 in a month for the 2019 In My Bag Tour. You can learn more about that on Dope for Degrees website, on the actual website for the In My Bag Tour, YouTube, all those things. Thanks for watching. If you want to contact me one-on-one to talk about this a little bit more, the link will be in the description box below. You can also join me on Sundays. I go live every single Sunday on Dope for Degrees YouTube channel to answer any questions you have about scholarships at 3 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I go live every Sunday at 3 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I just hope you have a great time raising the money you need to go to college. Because college is an investment. It's an investment meaning that you are going to put something in to hopefully get a return. And the best way to ensure that you get the best return on your investment is to decrease or possibly eliminate the amount of student loan debt you tack on or you take on. So be proactive, not reactive. Let's get to work. I'll see you soon.